Hello, I'm Steve with Touch the Master's Hand, Holy Spirit Ministries. I wanted to talk today about this. I've been having a lot of dreams lately, and the Lord will give me actually specific scriptures, but this one was all about 316. And so I need y'all's help, the significance of it, but anyhow, I'm going to kind of dive into it. He told me, he said, Colossians 3:16 was just as important as John 3:16. We all know John 3:16. Everybody loves that scripture, you know, awesome, jump through the roof, da-da-da. It is an awesome scripture. It's on the front of my Bible. But let me read 3:16. 3:12, actually, but all the way down to 16. But 16, but it's all about how we treat each other and how we are to each other. And this is 3:16. I'm just going to kind of read. I'm going to stay in a 3:16 vein, but let the word of Christ dwell in you richly in all wisdom, teaching and admonishing one another in psalms and hymns and spiritual songs, singing with grace in your heart to the Lord. And then 17, and whatsoever you do in word or deed, do all in the name of the Lord Jesus, giving thanks to God the Father through him. Earlier on in 12, it's all about if we have a fault with somebody, we're supposed to forgive them like Jesus forgave us. But this is about how we treat each other, guys, in the body. Even in the world, too, of course. But, you know, it's kind of hard to do sometimes because people don't listen and sin. There's just a lot of stuff that we don't want to jack with. But that can creep into the church, too. But, so, he told me, he said, this was just as important. And then 2 weeks later, so I'm kind of studying on this 3:16. It's like, I don't get it all. But so a couple weeks later, he said, Matthew 3:16 is a key verse of a different level. And I'm like, okay, there's another 3:16. So let's go to Matthew 3:16. Just kind of bear with me, guys, because I'm just at the end. I'm going to tell you a few things, too. Let's go to Matthew 3:16. Bear with me while I find it in my Bible. I'm a little slow, but I will get there. Matthew 3:16. When he had been baptized, Jesus came up immediately from the water, and behold, the heavens were opened to him, and he saw the Spirit of God descending like a dove and alighting upon him. And suddenly, 17, and suddenly a voice came from heaven saying, this is my beloved Son, in whom I am well pleased. So there's another 3:16. So I'm going somewhere with this. I'm not 100% sure, but I'm going somewhere with this. I know I'm going somewhere, I just don't know what. But that is a key scripture. How we treat each other, how Jesus treated us through John 3:16, his only Son. That was God's salvation plan, and then how we treat each other. And then Jesus was baptized. It is a key. Been taken out of the church, guys, a lot of churches. It's like, man, they overlook that scripture, they take it out, they don't do it. It's like, okay, Son of God, he had to be baptized. Who is Jesus? And God's, you know, and he had a limited time on the earth. And God had an orchestrated plan. And he took the time to get baptized. Jesus took the time to get baptized. So, there are some keys. And then he said, Mark 3:16, let's go to there. I'm getting somewhere with this, and it's a little bit deeper than this. That's pretty deep already. I know, I get it. But this is just kind of scriptures in the right order. I'm going to make this one kind of short. I'm really bad about making long videos. I'm trying not to. There's so much to share with you guys. This was all in dreams. I've been having dreams and they've been specific. One day I'm going to share just a video about just all these different scriptures. And Matthew, or Mark 3:16. Simon, to whom he gave the name Peter. It's about Jesus picking one of his primary disciples. But earlier on, it's about healing the sick, casting out, you know, giving the power to heal the sick, to preach, cast out demons. You know, you kind of need to read around it too, above and below it too. These are just scriptures that you highlight, but for some reason it's been 3:16. You know, it's like, okay, God, I kind of need to study a little bit more on it, dive into it a little bit more. And so it's just kind of been on my mind. It's like, man, 3:16. And then he said, there's other 3:16s all throughout the Bible. And he said, go to the prophets. Go to Revelation. So, Daniel, I'm going to kind of paraphrase it a little bit. The scripture in Daniel is about the king harassing them, and it's like, and they're like, we don't owe you an explanation, king. We don't owe you anything. You know, they stood up for God. They stood up for what they knew was right. Revelation. Let's read Revelation. Not a good scripture. Not what everybody wants to hear. Not what the world or the politically correct religious culture that's twisted up is saying. Revelation 3:16. So then, because you are lukewarm and neither hot, not cold nor hot, I will spew you, I will vomit you out of my mouth. Because you say, I am rich, I have become wealthy, and have needed nothing, and do nothing, that you are wretched, miserable, poor, blind, and naked. And I can, you know, that's why I said go. Read around it. These are the scriptures that God's highlighting, but it's like, okay. So then I'm still on this theme. It's been over the past couple of weeks. Colossians 3:16, it's just as important as John 3:16, how we treat each other in the body. Because we're God's children. We're His glory. That's another one of my messages. How we're His glory. He told me to write another book, which I am. Christ in You, the Hope of Glory. It's coming out in January. I didn't want to do it that quick, that soon. It's a long, long story. I'm like, dang, I got a little help here. Kind of don't have it. I knew the message, and I knew what it meant, and I knew the depth of it. And I'd heard it since the 80s. Where's glory, guys? How are we treating one another? Whether it's the pastor or the guy or gal sitting next to you in the church, or the church janitor, or the choir, or the person that's unsaved. So then today, I was thinking about this and just putting this little message together, and I was like, God says all throughout the Bible, 3:16. So I'm like, I don't know the significance of 3:16, guys. I need some help here from you guys. Comment, tell me. This is not some New Age astro whatever in the stars message. Maybe there's no significance in it, but it's got highlighted. Like, okay, and then they're all over it. So I looked in Ezekiel, I looked in Daniel, I looked in, and then I went to Genesis. That's one people aren't probably going to like. You can misquote it, mistake it out of context, use it to dog people, which some do, you know. They twist scriptures to fit their own little quirky needs. Power and prestige, and, you know, whether it's over race, gender, whatever. But then I went to Exodus. And I'm like, okay. He told me to go to the Old Testament too. He said it's all throughout the Old Testament. Wow. So some I liked and some I didn't like. But, you know, I'm just kind of just doing all of them. I'm going through all of them. So it's like, okay, God, I just need to really kind of dive into this. But Exodus was a really cool one. So was Matthew. So was Colossians. Revelation, not so cool. If that's who you are, lukewarm. Before I go to Exodus, that's like a cup of coffee, you know? Everybody loves hot coffee. People love cold coffee. I've reached my coffee cup before and it's been lukewarm, and if I was close to a sink, I spit it out. This doesn't taste good. And the flavor, a horrible flavor, or bitter, or whatever, you know? It's just, so, but, a little bit more depth to the one about in Revelation, you know, because you're talking about life and death, right? Your soul. But Moses 3:16. Why would these scriptures love can stand by themselves, just the scripture by himself. You don't even have to read, you know, partiality of it. It's like they're standalone. Exodus 3:16. Go and gather the elders of Israel together and say to them, the Lord your God, your father, the God of Abraham and Isaac and of Jacob, appeared to me saying, I have surely visited you and seen what you have done in Egypt. And I said, I will bring you up out of the affliction of Egypt to the land of the Canaanites, into the Hittites and Amorites. Anyhow, you kind of got to read around it. But 15, moreover, the God said to Moses, thus you shall say to the children of Israel, the Lord God of your fathers, the God of Abraham and the God of Isaac and the God of Jacob has sent me to you. This you will tell. This is my name forever, and this is my name, my memorial to all generations. So he, you know, he's highlighting these specific scriptures, and I'm kind of going around, not around them, but I'm looking, putting the pieces of this puzzle together, and I'm always highlighting 3:16. Some of them are really standalone, some of them are putting in the context of the scripture around it. There's a message in there, guys. I'm finding parts of it, not all of it, so I'm going to study it. But anyhow, that's kind of where I'm at with this one. Is John 3:16? Is this just as powerful of a scripture as Colossians 3:16? So how are we treating our brothers and sisters in the Lord? I'm not talking about, because I'm not there yet. I'm still working on delivery. I'm 10-year Pentecostal background, 9-10-year holiness background, holiness or hell. I get the judgment piece. I get to put the hammer down. I get the axes laid at the root of the tree. I get all that. You wear earrings, you're going to hell, hoops or whatever, you know. There is judgment. I don't get all the revelation, but I'm not the judgment guy. I'm not preaching judgment because God's telling me it's a little bit different. And then there's the other side. Love, love, love. Everything's love. Awesome. John 3:16 is all about God to love the world. That is where he's at. He told me to plow down the middle. Because that kind of, some of that in the charismatic swirl and other swirls kind of reminds me of the hippie days. Drugs, sex, and rock and roll. Love, 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 love. You know, it's like me, 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 me. Flesh, 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 flesh. Now you can't pick and choose the scriptures you like. I sat in there this one minister and he made me laugh. I was like, you know, be preaching like, you don't like that page in the Bible? Rip it out. Guarantee you'll have a holy Bible after not too long. It'll be so holy you won't even recognize it. So full of holes. You can do the Ezekiel 3. A righteous man falls and you warn him not, and he perishes, blood's on your hands. How could a righteous man fall? How could somebody that once was saved? You can go down all kinds of rabbit holes with that. But you don't warn him. But if you warn him, and he repents, then his blood's not on your hands. So, you know, guys, it's like in Matthew, and was last night at the shelter, one of the parts that I preached at the shelter. I think it's Matthew 7. But it says, you know, men are going to come to him in the last day, at the end time, and say, you know, Lord, let us in. He's going to say, depart from me, for I knew you not. Your work was of iniquity. 5 wise and 5 foolish virgins. Half of them don't make it in. Is that half the church? Is that half the world? I don't know. People aren't going to make it in. Heaven and hell is real. So, you know, scripture's about the tares. The wheat and the tares grow together. Scripture's about vessels. In a good house, there's many vessels, some silver, wood, gold, some for honor and some for dishonor. What do you do with all those scriptures? What do you do with the one I just read about Revelation? Lukewarm, you're going to spit you out. Half, 1 foot in the church, 1 foot not. I kind of trust God, I kind of don't. I do my own thing. I go Sunday for 45 minutes and I'm a good guy or gal. Really? Okay. Where's your relationship with Him? So that's another one of my messages, really. Who's your source? Don't even listen to me. I'm not your source. I'm just the vessel. 38 years to get here. I don't have the judgment hammer and cloak because, guess what? My robe wasn't always white. I got a prodigal son experience. I get the grace piece. I understand that. I was angry at God for something I did. Ignorant, blind, did whatever I wanted, whatever the hell I wanted to. I still asked God for help in amongst that, and He did in amongst my mess. But I got to that place of grace and realized it. That's a whole other story. But so it's like I can't be the finger pointing guy, because if CNN or whatever ever did an article on me or my life, it'd be like, man, there's a lot of mess, guys. Messy Marvin. Come to God, I'm like, man, God, here I am again. So, anyhow, there's a lot to this, guys. We need to get over ourselves. What's God showing us? What's He trying to teach us? Are we listening? You know, it's like this. I'm going to end with this. The cell phone, okay? Cell phone. It rings. Hello? Pick it up, whatever. My wife calls, my son calls, one of my kids calls, and one of the three, sister, my grandkids. I individually recognize each one of their voices. Instantly. If you've got one of God's children, you know His voice. Don't let the enemy trick you into that. It's just, I'm going to end with this. Are you listening? One time I was in the midst of a pretty fiery trial, and I was really broken hearted. Busted up, tore up, crying, and just, man, it was just, my heart broke. Tore up, and I'm like, God, what do I do with this? I'm only mad at you. I don't understand it. It was a life and death situation. Kind of normal things to go through, but it was just, it really hurt. It was really hurt. I was like, man, God. How could this be such a tragic situation? So quick, so soon, whatever, you know? It was years ago. And then I did get a little angry. And I'm like, finally, like, God, are you even listening to me? I didn't have to even, you know? God, are you even, went for 2 days. God, are you even listening to me? I don't think so. Doesn't feel like it. I don't see you. Where's my answer? This could go on and on. I finally got my answer, guys. I didn't like it. He spoke to me. I'm going to know something. He spoke to me, and he said, sorry, that was my wife. She didn't know that I was recording a video. He spoke to me, and he said, no, are you really listening to me? And my heart sank, guys, a little bit. I had to get a little neology out there. I don't know if that's, you know, however you want to look at that term. I'm just afraid about it. Like, man, God. Okay, God. I am sorry. No, I'm not really listening to you on this. Or other situations or whatever, you know. So, I'll leave you with that. Who's your source? Who are you listening to? The news? The world around you? Unsaved church? Or people that are claiming to be Christians that aren't, false prophets. I turn on the YouTube and it's like, man, all this crap. God, I don't even know if I, you know, all different political mess, religious mess, stuff. It's like, man, I don't even want to pollute my brain. I don't want to waste the brain power with that. I mean, you really got to pray about what you're feeding your mind. Because they don't even listen to me. I'm just You know, but listen to this one direction. Get it straight from the source. Be like you live in Missouri. Show me state. God, show me in your word. God, talk to me. Spoken word. And prayer. Supplication. God, what is it, God? What are you trying to teach me? Show me. Get it straight. You got, that's what Jesus was about. Giving you instant access to God. Go through the Old Testament. How many people in the Old Testament got a hold of God, really, honestly? Go pick them out. Name them. But yeah, we want to stamp God's name on everything. Well, God's plan was Jesus. That's taken out of the church and a lot of churches, and they claim to be Christians. It's like hoodwinking God. They see through all that. I'm the way, the truth, and the life. No man can see the Father except through me. What are you going to do with that scripture? You know? I mean, I'm just telling you guys. Dig deep for yourself. Get it in yourself. Now when I open my Bible in the morning time, because God will give me the scriptures, this is my prayer. God, let this enter into my heart. Stir, move, become part of me. Just do whatever you got to do, God. However this works, before I even open my Bible and start reading it about some of these scriptures you've given me, man, God, I really give this to me. Let it get in my heart. Do what it's supposed to do. Sometimes it's not pretty. Sometimes it's not pleasant. Sometimes it's kind of messy. Sometimes it hurts. And sometimes it's great and awesome and just boom, I'm on top of the mountain. I'm ready to rumble. You're going to storm the gates of hell. But, you know, so I'm just telling you guys, that's the direction I'm giving you. Who's your source? Bible, God, Jesus, the Holy Spirit. Most of this stuff, God, just, okay. You know? And there's a lot of good ministers out there, a lot of good men and women. I'll throw that one out there, that one's free. You gotta just kind of guard your heart about who you're listening to, and what you're listening to, and what you're letting your eyes see, and what you're popping up on YouTube and clicking on, and all that stuff. So anyhow, God bless you. Give me some feedback on this, where 316 is, because like I said, it's kind of like, man, it's kind of going through the Bible, it's all over the place. I don't have an answer yet. I don't know what the significance of it is, or if there even is any significance. Maybe this is something God wanted me to, the direction and the journey He wanted me to go. I need to dive into that a little bit. But anyhow, God bless you. Thanks for listening. Sorry for the interruption of my wife. She didn't know. She was out there in the living room studying or doing whatever she's doing, and I'm kind of doing this in the quiet back corner of the house. But we love you guys, and we'll see you soon. There you go, find out what the missus wanted.